Hi, I'm Gary Namie, Director of the Workplace Bullying Institute. Thanks for visiting our website. I appreciate it a lot. And the heavy traffic shows to us how big of a problem workplace bullying really is. We do the surveys, we know that, but it's good to see that people care in increasing numbers. Now, I could define bullying for you. It's at the website. Go ahead and read it. But let me tell you what really outrages me about bullying. It is a systematic, laser-focused campaign of interpersonal destruction. A unilaterally declared war by the perpetrator, by the bully, on a couple targets. And they do this because they cannot stand the competence, the strength, the emotional intelligence, the likability of the targeted person. They just want to get rid of them. And they'll do anything shamelessly and utterly creatively to destroy that person's career, health, family cohesion, and standing in the workplace. They will tear them apart from coworkers, so they'll terrify coworkers so that they'll never defend their bullied friend again. And that's how they do it. And they play those games. They'll use political influence up the hierarchy and bring it down to crush the target. And in our 14 years of doing this, I can tell you that that's what bullying is, and what it is not is conflict. It's not conflict between two equally powered parties, so there's no sense having the conflict resolution types come on in and claim to be bullying experts. They can just take their mediation games and leave town because mediation doesn't work. The person's already compromised. You don't compromise the compromised. This is psychological violence. Bullying is violence, and it needs a different set of tools to stop it. In our consulting business, The Work Doctor, we've mastered what those tools are, and we do it for organizations who actually care to stop bullying. But it is not conflict. The solutions have to involve making a person healthy, because it's the health harm that drives the whole movement. My wife, Dr. Ruth, was tormented by her clinical supervisor in a psychiatry clinic, and that woman's name was Sheila. And she drove Ruth to PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder, a strong emotional impact. But stress-related physical complications are also important. Cardiovascular compromises, from hypertension all the way up through heart attack. And then there are the gastrointestinal problems. This is a health hazard. Bullying is a health hazard. Interestingly, the Canadian laws and European laws are codifying bullying into their occupational health and safety codes. It is a workplace health hazard. Of course, in America, we've got the issue of, hey, bullying is just a management style and practice. Well, that's why we launched the Healthy Workplace Bill campaign. We've been working since 2002 to get the legislation passed. Hasn't passed yet, but it's sure gaining momentum. Won't you sign on and join the campaign? That's at healthyworkplacebill.org. Please don't forget that. That's an important part to push employers who choose to basically promote the bullies and sustain the bullies by rewarding the bullies. This will push them and prod them to do the right thing. They should pay attention to the bottom line. Right now, the bottom line doesn't even matter in these tough economic times. When the bully is Bob, Bob can do no wrong. Well, Bob needs to be outed for doing wrong. So help us and the legislative campaign. Continue to visit the site. We'll continue to provide you with more and more information. And we have a new book coming out this year in 2011. So look forward to your support and encouragement. Thanks.